Hey everyone, welcome back to Fix My Linux, the place where we simplify Linux for everyday users, developers, DevOps, and sysadmins. Today I've got a super useful video lined up for you. We're diving into some of the most important advanced Linux commands you'll ever need, especially if you're working without a GUI, managing a server remotely, or just want to level up your terminal skills. I'll walk you through everything from checking disk space, monitoring memory, managing processes, to creating users and groups. No fluff, just real examples. So let's get started. DF, report file system space usage. Let's say you're running low on disk space and want to find out where it's being used. The DF command is your best friend. Just type DF and you'll see details for all mounted file systems. But those big numbers might be a bit hard to read, right? No worries, add the dash H option like this, df-h, and now the output is in megabytes and gigabytes. Much easier to understand. For example, you might see something like 6.4 gigabytes used for your root directory instead of a long, unreadable number. That's it for DF, quick and simple. Free display amount of free and used memory. Next up, you might notice your system lagging, especially on a server or while hosting a site. That's when free comes in handy. Just type free to see RAM and swap usage. You'll get used, free, and available memory details. If you want a total summary including swap, try, free dash t even better, use, free dash h for a human readable format. Combine both like this, free dash th, and now you're looking at clear memory stats in megabytes or gigabytes. Easy to keep an eye on your system's health. Uptime, how long the system has been running. Ever wondered how long your system has been on without a restart? Maybe you're troubleshooting or just curious. Just type uptime and it'll show you the days, hours, and minutes the system's been running. If that format looks messy, try uptime-p for a cleaner, readable duration. And if you want to know exactly when the system was started, uptime-s gives you the date and time. Super useful. Last, list logins on the system. Let's say you're a sysadmin or just curious who logged into your system recently. Run the last command and you'll see a full list, usernames, IP addresses, login and logout times. If the name's too long, use last-w to see full usernames. It's a great way to audit logins or see if someone forgot to log out. Lastlog, most recent login of all users. Now maybe you want to check login history for all users, not just recent ones. Type lastlog and you'll see the last login for every system user, including system accounts like root or www data. If a user has never logged in, that's normal for system accounts. To filter for one specific user, combine it like this, lastlog pipe grep username. Who is logged on? The w command shows who's currently logged in and what method of login they used. Type w and you'll get usernames, IPs, login times, and what TTY they're using, like TTY1. If the same user logged in twice, for example once locally and once via SSH, you'll see both sessions. A quick way to check real-time user activity, lsusb, list USB devices. Ever plugged in a USB and wondered if Linux even detected it? Type lsusb and you'll see all USB devices connected to your system. For example, if you plug in a pen drive and it's not showing up in the file manager, check here. If it's listed, the system recognized it, even if the file manager didn't. Once removed physically, run lsusb again to confirm it's gone. Simple and effective. lscpu, display CPU architecture info. Want to know what kind of CPU you're working with? Just type lscpu and you'll see full details, architecture, supported modes, cores, cache, virtualization, and more. Whether you're using a 32-bit system like Raspberry Pi or a 64-bit desktop, this command gives you the full scoop. Neofetch, display system info in a cool way. Want a fun way to show off your Linux system? Try neofetch. First, install it using sudo apt install neofetch, then run it with neofetch. You'll get a clean, colorful summary, OS, host, kernel, uptime, packages, shell, CPU, GPU, RAM, plus your distro logo. Great for screenshots or just checking system info at a glance. Top, display Linux processes. If you've used Task Manager in Windows, you'll love Top. type top, and it shows all running processes, CPU and memory usage, tasks, uptime, users, everything. You can monitor real-time system performance right from your terminal. PS. Snapshot of current processes. Want a simple list of running processes? Type PS. It shows processes just for your session. For a complete system-wide view, run p-aux. You'll see process IDs, CPU memory usage, and the command that started each one. Want to filter for a specific app? Combine it with grep like this. Pass-aux pipe grep nginx kill --- terminate a process. If a program hangs, find its PID using PS, then terminate it with kill command. For example, sudo kill -9 PID. If there's no output, it worked. You can confirm by running the app check again, like curl localhost for nginx. Remember, don't kill your SSH session if you're connected remotely, or you'll get disconnected. Killall kill processes by name. Tired of searching PIDs? Use killall to kill processes by name. For example, sudo killall nginx. Just make sure the name matches exactly as seen in ps- aux pipe grep service name. If you type it wrong, like nginxd or nginx server instead of nginx, it won't work. So always double check the exact process name. Userdel, create a new user. Creating a new user, use useradd, but don't forget sudo. Example, sudo useradd ms/bin/bash-test-user. That creates the user, assigns a home directory, and sets bash as their default shell. Check the user with /etc/passwd-pipe-grep-test-user-su-switch-user to switch users or run commands as another user. Use su, for example, su root or su test user. If the user has no password set yet, it'll fail. But don't worry, we'll fix that next. Passwd, set or change a user password. If you just created a user or need to reset a password, type sudo passwd username. Set it once, confirm it, and you're good to go. Then test it by switching users again with su. Now you'll be inside the correct user shell. Groupadd, create a new group. Let's say you want to set up a team or department with restricted access, like a finance group. Use sudo groupadd, group name. You can check it with /etc/group --grep group name. It's a good first step for setting up group-based permissions. Groups. Show user group memberships. Finally, to check what groups a user belongs to, use groups for the current user or group's username for others. It's handy when setting permissions or debugging access issues. Usermod, modify a user account. Let's say you already have a user and a group, and now you want to add the user into that group. That's where the usermod command comes in. To add a user to a group, we use this command, sudo usermod --g groupname username. Here, -a means append and -g means group. Simple. So I'm adding test user to test group. Let's check it with groups@test user, and yep, you can see that the user is now part of both groups. Perfect. Deluser, remove user from group. Alright, now let's say you want to remove that user from the group. We use the deluser command for this, but keep in mind this one flips the order, sudo deluser username group name. So when I remove test user from test group, it gives a clear message. And when I check again using group's test user, it confirms the removal. Nice and clean.
Userdel, delete a user account. Now let's talk about deleting a user entirely. Before we run the userdel command, we can check the user's home directory using ls/home. If you want to delete both the user and their home directory, use sudo userdel --r username. The -r option removes home and mail files too. Run ls again, and you'll see the user's home directory is gone. Mission accomplished. Ifconfig, configure network interfaces. So, we've used IPA before, but another classic way is with ifconfig. If it's not installed, just run sudo apt install nettools, then type ifconfig to view interfaces and IPs. Want to filter just IPs? Try ifconfig pipe grep inet, easy to separate. Inet means IP4 and inet6 means IPv6 addresses. That's a quick peek into your network setup. Netstat, check network connections. Let's say you want to see all open network connections and listening ports. The netstat command does exactly that. Just type netstat, or if you want to see only listening ports, netstat dash L. This shows which IP and port are actively waiting for connections. Great for troubleshooting web servers or applications. Treat directory structure in tree format. We've all used ls before. But what if you want to see your folders like a tree format? Try the tree command. First, install it. Sudo apt install tree, then just run tree to see everything laid out beautifully. You can also use tree-t to show only directories or tree-af to show full paths. Great tool to visualize your file system. Head, view first few lines of a file. Got a huge file but only want to see the start? Use head. Example, head-n3 file name. This shows the first three lines. Change the number to see more or less as you like. It's really handy for previewing logs or config files quickly. Tail, view last few lines of a file just like head, but in reverse. Command is tail-n3 file name shows the last three lines. This is great for checking recent log entries without opening the whole file. More view file content page by page. Ever opened a long file and couldn't scroll to the top in the terminal? Use the more command. Try cat access.logpipe more. Now press the down arrow or spacebar to move through the file page by page. It's super useful for log file debugging. Less, better than more, now less is like more, but better. It scrolls line by line with arrow keys. Use cat access.logpipe less. Down arrow scrolls one line, but spacebar scrolls one full page, same as more. Very handy when you want precision scrolling. Diff, compare files line by line. Ever wondered what's different between two files? Diff shows you line by line changes. Run diff file 1 file 2. It shows the changes with arrows, left arrows for file 1, right arrows for file 2. Check with cat to confirm. Great tool for version comparison. SSH, remote terminal login. Need to access another Linux machine remotely? Use SSH. Syntax, SSH-P port username at IP once connected, type view me to confirm. If the default port 22 is used, you can skip the -p part. Really useful for DevOps, especially in headless systems. One of the most powerful use cases of SSH is in IT automation tools like ANS, IBLE. Ansible leverages SSH to connect and manage remote systems without requiring any additional software or agent to be installed on the target machines. That's why Ansible is often referred to as an agentless automation tool. It simply uses SSH to securely execute tasks on remote systems, making setup and maintenance much easier. LN, create hard and soft links. Linux allows file linking, hard links, and soft symbolic links. For a hard link, lndocuments/sample.txt/downloads/ edit one file. And the changes reflect in the other. Even deleting one won't affect the other unless you delete the original. For soft link, ln-sdocuments/sample.txt/downloads/. This creates a symbolic link, just a pointer. If you delete the original, the link breaks. Awesome for organizing files without duplicating them. Zip compress files. Want to send multiple files easily? Just zip them. Install it first. Sudo apt install zip, then run zip output file 1 file 2 file 3. Now list your files with ls and you'll see your zip file ready to go. 7z-list files in a zip archive. Now to peek inside a zip file, use 7z. It also has the best compression ratio. Install it first. Sudo apt install 7zip, then run 7zl your file.zip. It shows file types, sizes, and full details. Super useful before extracting anything. Unzip, extract zip files. To extract zip files, use the unzip command. Example, unzip-d-destination folder yourfile.zip, check with tree to confirm everything got extracted properly. Cal, show calendar in terminal. Yes, Linux terminal has a built-in calendar. If it's not available, install with sudo apt install nkl, then just run cal or nnkl to view the month. Try cal 2025 or nkl 2025 for the full year. use cal-5 for the next 5 months. Similarly, cal-b5 to check previous 5 months. Cool way to check dates when working on a headless server. FW, Firewall Management Linux is secure by nature, but you can add a firewall layer using UFW. First, check the status. Sudo UFW status. If inactive, enable it. Sudo UFW enable. Just be careful if you're on SSH. Let's block a port with sudo ufw deny from 192.168.561 to any port 82. And allow again by replacing deny with allow. Super powerful tool to protect your system. Systemctl, manage services. Want to start or stop services like nginx or apache? Use systemctl. Start a service. Sudo systemctl start nginx. Check service status. Sudo systemctl status nginx. Stop it. Sudo systemctl stop nginx. Restart. Sudo systemctl restart nginx. This is your go-to for managing services in Linux. Reboot your Linux system. Sometimes after updates or crashes, you just need a reboot. Use sudo reboot. This immediately restarts your system. Be careful if you're on SSH. It will disconnect you. Shutdown, power off Linux system. Now, if you want to shut down your system, use the shutdown command, type sudo shutdown. It schedules shutdown and gives a broadcast message. If you change your mind, you can cancel with sudo shutdown dash c. To shut down system instantly, sudo shutdown now. Great when you want to save power or shut down after updates. Alright, that's a full deep dive into essential Linux commands that go beyond just the basics. If you've made it this far, you've just leveled up your Linux skills big time. If this video helped you, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to Fix My Linux. Drop a comment below if you want tutorials on any specific command or concept. I'd love to make it happen. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video. Keep learning, keep exploring at Fix My Linux.